we're actually up in the mountains. We're in a high desert situation, 5,500 to 6,000 feet. So we've been here about a little over 100 years, and our kids are the fifth generation to grow up out in this area. We grow all dry land crops out here. We don't have water here on our farm, and so we rely on rain for everything. Our farm is based around wheat and safflower, but we also incorporate mustard and dry peas. We're trying to work a little bit with winter canola. Eastern Idaho specifically is very heavily dependent on ag. I think we would miss it tremendously if agriculture wasn't here. The weather is extreme, and that is probably one of the most difficult things about farming here, to be honest. In the summer, we can have like a 40, 50 degree swing like it's nothing. This last June, we actually had, it was June 22nd, we spent the better part of the night below freezing. So you can imagine my husband and I spent the better part of the night not sleeping, but it's really frustrating when all of your blood, sweat, and tears is out there on the line. And Mother Nature's calling the shots at that point. We get the best of both worlds here in our house. My husband is an educated engineer, and I went to school for accounting. And so all of my focus is all around business management, our office situation, all of our accounting. And that's my contribution. We learned really early in our farming career that good data helps you make good decisions. I think something I would love for consumers to know and lawmakers to know is that farming is not just a job. It's a passion. It's a lifestyle. So for farm families, it is our world. Farming is our world. Crop insurance is one of those things that lets you sleep a little bit better at night, because it might mean that you have a crop failure, or you have a yield that is not what it could have been, but at least you're not out of business. At least you can come next year and try it again.